Hello and welcome to the show. Now, investing in property is a good way to look after your money, but it's not always a sure thing. There are risks involved.
Yeah, and often if it sounds too good to be true, then that means it probably is. And one way to find value is at your local property auction. Property under the hammer is very popular, but it's not for everyone. But it can be surprisingly straightforward.
Yes, but you always have to do your research. Let's find out what today's buyers went for.
On the Suffolk coast, I find a few issues. I have spotted damp throughout the flat, but in this room, you can really see it. In South Yorkshire, Dion's looking for the positives.
It hasn't got great kerb appeal at the moment, but it looks pretty solid.
And in Cambridgeshire, Tommy spots a few things out of place.
It has some serious-looking cracking to the front, and there's a forest growing out of the guttering.
All these properties have been sold at auction, and we'll find out who bought them and what they paid for them when they went under the hammer.
Sold. Congratulations. Well bid.
I'm in the glorious seaside town of Lowestoft, which was once famous for its fishing industry. So much so, a herring and ale fair takes place here every year. Nowadays, it's becoming one of the leading centres in the UK for renewable energy, making this coastal town move with the times. But for me, the highlight of living in this location is this, the unspoilt sandy beaches right on your doorstep. I'm sitting on a beach of gold. So, with all the attractions this seaside town has to offer, it's great to find a property for sale at auction in this highly sought-after area known as Pakefield. And you've got the beach literally just 100 metres down the road. And here it is. It's a one-bed, first-floor flat situated in this building, and it went to auction with a guide price of £50,000. I'm going to head through and up. Wow. Really, really steep stairs. But it's nice to have your own entranceway. So, into this rather long corridor, you've got rooms to the right, which I'll have a look at later, and then rooms to the left. Nice and bright, actually. Haven't seen any signs of central heating, just these electric storage heaters. You've got a somewhat of a kitchen there. I'll have a look at that in a bit. And then into quite a bright living dining room. You've got dual aspects, so lots of light coming through. A decent size, actually, which is not too bad. But once again, I can see those sort of electric storage heaters. Now, the Energy Performance Certificate rating, or the EPC rating for this flat, is currently G, which is seriously low. So you've got to think about changing those heaters and insulation as well. Oh, heat me up. So into a half kitchen kind of thing. You've got a kitchen sink here. The brick wall feature continues once again. I'm not sure if whether they were chimney breasts, but it's not a bad size actually. But the other alternative, if you wanted that open plan, entertaining space, then you could knock through and then create that one cohesive kitchen, living, dining. It's always good to have options. So, past the steep stairs to this side of the flat. Wow, that is a generous-sized bathroom. I do love a big bathroom. Of course, it's dated and, you know, you'd have to rip it all out and start all over again. But I think you could also definitely fit in a shower into that bathroom. Nice. And then into your bedroom. Now, I have spotted damp throughout in bits and pieces in the flat, but in this room, you can really see it. And it feels a little bit cold to the touch. Definitely get a damp-proof specialist in. Now, the other thing I have noticed is there's, you know, some sort of cracks here. I'd have to get that looked at. Finally, what I've noticed lots of things, but the other thing I have noticed throughout in this flat is all of the windows are single glazed. Now, you know what I'm going to say. To get your EPC rating soaring, you'll have to replace all of the windows with double glazing, and that will eat into your budget. Replacing all the windows will be a costly outlay, but the money saved long-term on your energy bills would make this investment well worth it. But could this flat, guided at £50,000, be a good earner? We asked along a property expert from the auction house that sold the lot for their opinion.
Well, it's definitely an auction property. It needs complete refurbishment throughout. It's got a nice feel about it, nice big windows, nice and light and airy. And also, I'm quite surprised about the amount of floor space there is. So I think it probably lend itself quite well to, although it's a one bedroom at the moment, to conversion possibly into a two bedroom. Obviously, if you're converting it into a two bedroom, you are losing some of the living space.
Yes, there is an option to make the living room an open plan kitchen living area, and then the kitchen could be turned into a bedroom. But would it make financial sense to do so?
This property was put on the market as a one bedroom when it's been fully done up. We'd say estimate around about £80,000 for that. If they manage to convert it into the two bedroom, then we'd probably be looking at something more with a nine in front, so we're probably looking at £90,000.
And how would adding a bedroom affect the rental values?
So for a one bedroom flat, I would suggest this property would rent out about £500 per calendar month. If it was managed to be converted into a two bedroom, you'd probably get a slight improvement on that figure.
Well, I like this flat. It's a blank canvas, and whatever you decide to do here, it's going to add value to what is a good, solid shell with decent-sized rooms. And don't forget, you've got the sandy beaches just 100 metres away, as well as the attractions of Lowestoft town on your doorstep. I think this is a cracking little flat. Let's see who agreed when it went under the hammer. This lot was sold at a remote property auction with bids taking place online.
First time, second time, third time. Sold. Congratulations.
For £55,000, the successful purchaser of this seaside flat was Tony. He's semi-retired and works part-time as a gardener, and he's working with his friend and business partner, Jacqui, on this project, which they hope will be the first of many together. Jacqui, Tony, lovely to meet you both.
And you too.
Nice to meet you too. Yeah.
And what a wonderful place you've got here. What made
you
buy
much.
This property?
Price?
Yeah.
Location? Yeah. 3 minute walk to the beach.
So is this what you do then, Jacqui? Is this?
Yes. Well, actually, I have an estate agency in London, in Surrey.
Yeah.
But basically, I have a building firm, so we do developments for clients, for pension portfolios and things like that.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, wow. And what's your background there, Tony?
Well, I'm semi-retired now.
Yeah.
But initially, it was finance for nearly 30 years.
Yeah.
And I was coming to this area before I met Jacqui.
Yeah.
And so a mutual friend of ours hooked us up together, and we thought, well, we'll try and do this sort of thing as a project, because Jack is used to doing it.
Oh, wow. So it's a perfect business partnership then, isn't it?
We hope.
So we've got the savvy property know-how, and we've got the financial holding onto the purse strings know-how as well.
Well, I recently sold, in July of last year, I sold a property. So I've got some funds sitting in a bank account. Not, as you know, very much interest, very poor interest rate. So this is an ideal way of using up some of those funds.
So what kind of work is going to happen here?
Well, Jacqui is the expert on that.
the chimney breasts were taken out, obviously, by the previous owners. So we're having those checked out just to make sure they did them properly.
Yeah.
And then we plan to take this from a one-bedroom to a two-bedroom with no structural work. So all cosmetic, basically. Rewire, replumb, new kitchen, bathroom, some minor works to be done to the roof just to stop the leaks and things like that.
Yes.
But nothing major.
Yeah.
But with no structural, not knocking down walls, but we are going to turn it into a two-bedroom flat.
Walk me through how you're going to turn this one bed into a two bed.
Big bedroom at the other end.
Yes.
Stays exactly the same. And then in this room, we're going to be putting in a sort of semi-open plan kitchen. So with two little half walls on either side here, which just return with a shelf behind, so there's an additional work surface, but it's enough to leave plenty of room for a sofa, table and chairs, couple, you know, an armchair.
And then...
And so the kitchen becomes a bedroom. Make it, it's a double bedroom.
Yeah.
With good lighting, it'll be fine.
Getting another bedroom in here is a good plan, but one thing to note is that the flat is a leasehold property, so it's always best to check the conditions of the lease before you make any alterations to the use of the rooms. You may need the permission of the freeholder before going through with the changes.
Gotta make a change. Ooh, gotta make a change.
Although, as Tony and Jacqui are going to be improving the roof insulation and windows, making the building watertight, the freeholder could see all the works being carried out as an improvement to their investment long term.
Once you've done all of that work, what's it going to look like, sort of aesthetically?
It's good. Well, first of all, we're trying to keep to very sustainable materials. So that's a really big thing for Tony. He wants it to be eco-friendly and sustainable. Mm. So it will have a, I mean, and I use the word advisedly, it'll be contemporary, it'll be quite modern.
Great.
It will look completely different, basically. Yeah.
And then, so what about the budget? How much are you going to be spending on this to turn this one into a two?
Well, we think it's, with Jacqui's costing, it's going to be around about 25,000.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, but there's no structural work, as you say, taking
place. No structural, new windows, and the biggest costs are things like the new sort of eco-friendly boiler and things like that. Rewiring, replumbing, and stuff, and replastering. So about 25,
Mm-hmm. And then time scale?
A month to 6 weeks.
Yeah.
So 4 to 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So you're going to start the work. You want to get in running and start the work straight away.
As soon as possible, really. Yeah.
Oh, he's keen.
Why not?
Well, time is money, isn't it?
Yeah. And then we can move on to something else. To this one. Should one come up, then. It might be an option to sell this one because the money's needed for another one.
Right.
Or other option is to maybe rent it out on a long-term basis. And the last option really is for, if there's nothing else, then for me to keep it and use it myself.
You're going to move in?
Yeah. not permanently, but use it myself and perhaps family and friends and people like that have it available for them.
That's quite
nice. So I've got plenty of options.
Yeah, so if you end up loving Lowestoft, then you might move in.
If Jacqui makes a really good job of it, I might not say, well, I'm keeping this for myself. Yeah.
Well, the very best of luck to
Thank you.
Thanks
much.
Very much.
Thank you.
Lovely.
Well, Jacqui and Tony seem to have all their plans in place to get the work done here, to turn this one bed into a two bed. Jacqui is a seasoned property developer, and Tony is keeping a keen eye on the finances. But how will they get on? And will they complete the work in 4 to 6 weeks? You can find out later in the programme. Off to South Yorkshire and the market town of Mexborough now, which is just 7 miles outside of Doncaster. It lies on the River Don and has good transport links, so a nice place to grab an auction lot.
So on this quiet residential street is the property I'm here to see. Here it is. It is an end of terrace house, two beds, had a guide price of £10,000 when it went to auction. Yes, £10,000 when it went to auction. Now, it hasn't got great kerb appeal at the moment, but it looks pretty solid. Let's have a look. Okay, first thing that hits you is this massive radiator, which is absolutely spot on when you're taking on a new refurb. Central heating is in, double glazed windows as well. The room itself is an okay size. It's not massive, it's not tidy, it's just dated, and it needs decorating with new carpets. Not a bad start. Okay, stairs leading to the bedrooms. Okay, so we have got a couple of issues in the kitchen, bit of damp underneath the working surface, and I can see that there has been some water damage above that kitchen window that's going into that small conservatory as well. The kitchen is dated, but it's a good size space. Get it all ripped out, Get some tiles on the wall, get some brand new flooring down, and a nice, bright kitchen in here will be fine. Maybe a little dining table here with some chairs, or even a breakfast bar would work in here. Listen, there's loads of space to play with here. You've just got to get it right, but you've got some work to do first.
There's a small conservatory that could act as a utility room. Then, outside, there's a small, low-maintenance back garden, making it potentially ideal for the rental market, as often, tenants aren't too keen on keeping on top of outside space.
OK, upstairs, we've got two bedrooms and a bathroom as well. The bedroom at the front of the house is a good size. It's a double bedroom. You'd fit some bedroom furniture in there as well, no problem at all. Central heating, good double glazed window. Over this side of the landing, you've got bedroom and you've got family bathroom as well. Now, it's not a huge family bathroom, but you've got one upstairs. Yeah, I'm guessing. Yeah, okay, so this would have been a bedroom back in the day, and that would have been the other one in regards no bathroom upstairs. They've done a good job. They've squeezed the family bathroom upstairs. That's always my preference. Needs a bit of work, needs modernising, it needs a bit of TLC.
Time to get the opinions and valuations of an expert from the auction house that sold this two-bed end terrace property, guided at just 10 grand.
There is already gas central heating here, but I think it would be advisable to check the boiler, check it's in working order. There is double glazing already in place. So I think it would be a case of going in, putting in a new kitchen, a new bathroom, laying down new carpets, just a general refurbishment.
With not a lot to be done, hopefully, what does the expert think the house could be worth on the rental and sales market?
So I think once refurbished, the property should be worth in the region of £75,000. And on the rental market, I believe it should fetch around £500 per calendar month.
This could be a really good project. It's a full refurb from top to bottom, and I haven't found any major issues. And don't forget, if you get it for anywhere near that guide price of £10,000, you're definitely onto something. Let's find out who wanted to take it on when I went under the hammer.
This lot was part of a remote auction with bids taking place online.
You bought it, well done, thank you.
It was Eddie who got the place for £42,000. He's roped in his friend's dad, Michael, to help with the renovations. Dion caught up with them to find out their plans. A brand new friend.
Eddie and Michael, nice to meet you.
Hello, you're okay?
Good property, solid property. Who's responsible for finding it?
I did.
Yeah, you're responsible.
Yeah.
So tell us, first and foremost, what's the relationship here? How's this working? Talk us through it, Eddie.
So James, who's Michael's little boy, Michael's son, I've been friends with him for about three to five years. And he's always said how busy he is working with his dad, and his dad is into this type of work, renovation and building. So I said, this sounds good. So why don't we link up? I guess let's see.
He thought he was going to get family and friends rates. He's not.
I love all that.
Yeah. And then Michael's come down, and it's been spot on. Honestly, I've been so grateful to have him so far. Like, because so much information.
This is going to be Eddie's first ever renovation, but he has previously looked after and managed rental properties before, so he's not a complete property novice. Plus, he'll have Michael, an experienced property developer, to guide him through the process. His friend James will also be involved in the work, but he has no renovation experience, so both him and Eddie will be learning as much as they can.
So what's the first thing we're going to do, Michael?
We're going to rip the kitchen out, fit a new kitchen in. We'll probably put an electric hob and electric oven in there. New gas boiler, we'll move it over that way a bit. And then that boiler will run the hot water and the central heating.
Any walls coming down?
No walls coming down, no. One or two of the walls will need replastering.
Okay.
But as you know, with these old buildings, the thicker the paper that's on there, the more it's trying to hide.
Correct.
But generally speaking, what we think, so replaster where necessary, I think we're okay.
And you've got a little sort of
conservatory
area there.
Yeah, that's already plumbed in for washing machine, and there's electrics out there. So probably the fridge will go out there.
A little utility.
Little utility room. Yeah, put a little line in so mm-hmm. you've got a bit of indoor drying.
Okay.
That sort of thing.
And upstairs we've got two bedrooms and a little bathroom. They've nicked a little space off the bedroom to put a bathroom up there as well. So that's staying as is, nothing changes upstairs?
Nothing's changing apart from new floorings going in and the same in the smaller room, the box room.
Okay.
We'll probably need to board some of the floors because the floorboards are like that. And again, get all the wallpaper off, see what we find when we get underneath, repair and redecorate.
Okay. What kind of budget have you got?
What's my budget or what's his?
Ah, there you go, good question. Eddie, what's your budget? What do you think you can get this place done for?
10,000 to 15.
Okay.
Obviously, I've been talking to Michael and he's on the same sort of wavelength as well.
Only because you told me you've only got 10 to 15.
There you go, that's fine. So get it done, please.
Please, that's all we have to work.
Ceiling 15, that is
no
it.
No pressure.
And how long is it going to take to do the work?
Once we get started and the trades are organised, when we're getting in, I'm probably looking at about 3 weeks.
Oh, really? That is sharp.
Well, yeah. I mean, if you can have a couple of trades here working at the same time. But there's no rewiring that needs doing. We'll rip the kitchen out. We'll have 4 or 5 people getting the carpets out, get the outside, and get everything out. Once everything is out...
You can see what you're working with, can't you?
Yeah, we'll see what we're working with. We can get the kitchen in, we can get the boiler in.
So when it's all done and it's all complete and Michael's, absolutely shattered, what are you going to do with it? Are you going to rent it, sell it, or are you going to live in it?
I think our first option would be to rent it out. That would be sort of our first go-to. And then second, if the market is good and it's friendly to us, if you like.
Pound signs.
then we might put it off on the market for sale.
Okay. Listen, chaps, Eddie, you're lucky to have him.
Yeah.
Michael, are you looking to have him? I'm not sure. More work for you. Listen, I hope it works out. You're doing the right thing and you're going about your business and your life in the right way. And when you've got someone like that, look after them.
Yeah.
Make sure you look after them.
God sent, definitely.
Absolutely. Listen, good luck. I hope it works out.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Well, Eddie has fallen on his feet. He's got Michael as his project manager with all his years of experience. He's a lucky boy. 10 to 15 grand budget. 3 weeks turnaround, bit tight for me, but you can find out how they get on later in the programme. Good luck, gents.
Still to come in Cambridgeshire, Tommy notices a theme.
There's an arch there, there's one around that window there, there's one to the fireplace.
And in South Yorkshire, Michael and James face a few unexpected issues.
That was a bit of a mission, delayed us a little bit, but it had to be done.
Back to Lowestoft now, and a one-bedroom flat in Pakefield that was guided at £50,000.
I fell in love at the seaside. I handled my charm with time and sleight of hand.
Just a short walk from the beach, this first-floor property was bright and spacious. But with no central heating and single glazed windows, it wasn't exactly energy efficient. Now, the Energy Performance Certificate rating, or the EPC rating, for this flat is currently G, which is seriously low. So you've got to think about changing those heaters and insulation as well.
Do you want to go to the seaside? I'm not trying to say that everybody wants to go.
And there was also one other minor issue in the bedroom.
Now, I have spotted damp throughout in bits and pieces in the flat, but in this room, you can really see it.
So there were a couple of issues that needed looking into, but overall, the flat was in good condition. The property was bought for £55,000 by Tony, who semi-retired and had teamed up with his friend and business partner, Jacqui, who was helping him with his first venture into property development.
Meet me down by the sea.
and she had big plans for the renovation.
What kind of work is going to happen here?
We plan to make this, take this from a one-bedroom to a two-bedroom with no structural work. So all cosmetic, basically. Rewire, replumb, new kitchen, bathroom, some minor works to be done to the roof just to stop the leaks and things like that.
Yes.
But nothing major.
With Jacqui's experience as a property developer and a budget of £25,000, they hoped to complete the renovation in 4 to 6 weeks. Now, 4.5 months later, we're back to see if they've done it. It definitely looks like those windows have been replaced, but what about the inside? The interior has been given a contemporary feel with white paint throughout. The reception room has been converted into a kitchen living area. And the old kitchen has become a second bedroom. Here's Tony and Jacqui to tell us exactly what they've done.
What we've actually done is everything. We ended up doing more than we thought we would do, which is replastering the entire property, moving what was the kitchen into what is now a sort of open plan reception room. So basically taking it back to the brick and starting again.
It sounds like there was a lot more work involved than originally planned. Jacqui has clearly excelled herself, but one of Tony's main requests was to make the flat as eco-friendly as possible. So how has Jacqui incorporated this into the renovation?
We've done as much as we can to make the flat fully compliant with green energy.
So things like the loft insulation's been done, the carpet is a thick carpet to retain the heat.
It's also got a thermal insulation underneath the carpet, so it's allowing heat to come from below, but trapping it, so it traps it in the underlay. The same with underneath the vinyl, so there's, even in the bathroom, there's a thermal insulation under the floor.
Tony and Jacqui's work here has made this flat more energy efficient, which means it's better for the environment and better for the utility bills. But what happened with the damp issue?
Most of it was superficial, it wasn't rising, a lot of it was condensation damp, but we were taking all the plaster off anyway, so we didn't really encounter any problems with that. We haven't had to do anything specifically about damp because we've taken it back, found out where the problem was. The biggest issue has been the delay in materials, shortage of materials and the cost of materials, because it's actually put the job, you know, the job cost up a little bit. So that was the biggest challenge, was delay on materials.
What have those rising material costs meant for Tony's 25 grand budget?
We've gone over that a little bit. We're up to about 32 now. There was a little bit more labour required, and when we came to buy different things like the boiler, for example, we spent a little bit more to get the boiler that we wanted to provide us with the outcome that we wanted. So all in all, little things that in the long run will make a lot of difference have pushed the price up.
So they've gone a little over budget, but by spending more on an eco-friendly boiler and adding all the proper insulations, they have made this flat more efficient for the long term. But have the changes made to the flat been worth it? We asked along a local estate agent to get his opinion on this now two-bedroom flat.
I think what they've done here is excellent. Personally, I think it was the right thing in making this into a two-bedroom because I think it's the perfect buy-to-let property. So therefore, you are going to get more money for renting it out as a two-bedroom.
It's a thumbs up for the two bedrooms. So what does he think the property will make if placed on the rental market?
I think this property would rent for £700 per calendar month.
That's exactly what we've had an offer of. We've got actually somebody who would rent it at £700 per calendar month.
That equates to a very healthy yield of just over 9%. Tony has a total of £87,000 invested into this property. So what returns is he likely to see if he sold it?
I'd put it on the market for £125,000.
Well, our original valuation for the property was between £120 and £130. But we've actually had somebody interested in it because we put it out to the market at £150 and we've had interest in it at £140.
If they're able to achieve that hoped-for figure of £140,000, Tony could be looking at a pre-tax profit of £53,000. It's clear that this has been a very successful partnership, But have the figures helped Tony to decide what he's going to do with his two-bed flat?
If it wasn't so nice and so near the beach, which is what I like, I would sell it straight away. But the fact of what I've just said puts a doubt in my mind of, do I really want to sell it or do I keep it? And to be honest with you, if it hadn't been for Jacqui and what she's done with this property, I wouldn't have been interested in doing another one. But she's done such a good job that I hope to work with her again in the future and buy another one.
Thank you.
Off to Cambridgeshire now, and 6 miles east of Peterborough, is the market town of Whittlesey. This fenland town has agriculture at the heart of its community. So much so that every January, a person is covered from head to foot in straw and made to look like a straw bear. They're then led from house to house to dance for gifts or food. But is the house Tommy's looking at somewhere to make a song and dance about?
The property I'm here to see is this one. It has some serious-looking cracking to the front, and there's a forest growing out of the guttering. In fact, there's only half the guttering in position. The other half is missing, and it's on the floor. So there will have been damage done by the ingression of stormwater. So we'll have to have a look inside and see how extensive the damage is. This property had a guide price of £150,000, and it's a three-bedroom detached house. We can't go in the front door because it's jammed shut, so we'll have to go via the tradesman's entrance round the back.
Well, it's not the best of starts, and the house, being close to the town centre, is in a conservation area, which might limit its development potential.
Interesting. This is a bit like a sort of conservatory lean-to. And it's been used as a utility area. And you can see, looking outside, that the greenery is beginning to take over. It's a bit like Day of the Triffids. Yeah, now, these units look like they're past their sell-by date, but actually, they're in pretty good nick. It's just that it's very, very dirty, but it's only superficial dirt. Spend half a day cleaning this right up, and you'd have it almost like brand new. This is like a recreation of the pub in the 70s with the decorative plaster panels all in white and these dummy beams all chopped out and painted black. And then we go through this arch and we're into the lounge. But whoever had this previously was a big fan of natural stone and arches, because there's an arch there, there's one around that window there, there's one to the fireplace. I'd have all that out, you don't want that, and then just repair the plaster. And then you've got a real nice background, if you like, to put in some nice pieces of your own touches.
This might have been deliberately made to look dated, but now it's just dated. But look beyond that, and there's certainly plenty of possibilities here. Can you see the bigger picture?
There's a massive bedroom here, a massive bedroom in here, and in here, a massive bathroom. And it's got a huge jacuzzi bath in the corner. Well, that was a surprise. I wasn't expecting that. And then even this third bedroom, the, if you like, small bedroom, it's huge for a small bedroom. And they've got problems here, the same on the rear elevation as on the front elevation, and that is the guttering is full of growth, vegetation growth, so they're not operating right. And what's happening here, when it rains, it's flying over the top of the guttering, down the wall, and blowing all the plaster off the wall. And it does more than that, it does structural damage over a period of time, because wet and cold, it expands, and then when it dries out, it shrinks, and that's how you get structural cracking appearing in the walls. And all that is unnecessary. All you've got to do is have the gutters cleared. It's just the simple things.
How easy and simple that would have been. And though it is easy to fix those gutters, the long-term effects will take time and money and were so easily avoided. It's just the simple things.
The burning question of the day, would you keep the conservatory? It's a bit like a, at the moment, it's no real practical use except as a utility space. So you can either keep it or get rid of it, and you, there is a possibility of knocking it down and building yourself an extension. But I think there's enough room within the building already. You don't need to create any more, just need to reconfigure what you've got. And I think you need to spend a bit more time and money out here in the garden. Huge garden, a walled garden right the way through. This could be a fantastic outside space. And we've come right the way, the full length of the garden. We've got a nice, good, hard stand here for a couple of cars. And then we've got this big shed thing at the bottom of the garden. Wow, look at this. Huge bench. Storage for all your screws and nails. We've got a little bit of the Triffids invasion again, but that could all be ripped out and cleaned up. And there's some missing panels, but a coat of paint and a tidy up. And this is a great space. And also, those doors, full size, open right up, so you could get vehicles in here. You could actually have a lovely classic car collection. Ooh. How much is this place?
Sorry, Tommy, you've missed the boat with this place. One thing you'd need to be wary of here is that the roof panels look like they're made of asbestos. You'd need to bring in a specialist to look at that before you did any work on this outbuilding. We know Tommy loves this house, but what will a local estate agent make of it?
It's a really good property. Lots of room for improvement with it. I think it offers you the ability to extend. Has a lot of potential to modernise, make it your own. And yeah, it's fantastic. Really good property.
And is that option of an extension replacing the lean-to worth pursuing?
I think adding a downstairs extension would be great for the property, and I think it'd make it more sellable. Do I think it would add additional value? I'm not convinced.
This house was guided at £150,000. So what kind of resale value might it achieve?
Upon completion, with works done to a very good standard, I'd suggest a marketing price of £325,000.
And currently on the rental market?
The property would achieve somewhere in the region of around £950 per calendar month to £1,000 per calendar month.
This old house is feeling tired, damp. It needs a full programme of works to repair it and bring it back to its former glory. Let's see who had the vision, the budget and the willpower to see something like this through when this property went under the hammer.
This lot was part of a remote auction with bids taking place online.
Congratulations, well done.
For £209,750, these successful bidders were Julia and Rimple. They bought it as another project for their part-time property developing business, which they run alongside their husbands, Trevor and Killen. Tommy met them to find out more.
Well, Julia and Rimple, very nice to meet you.
And you.
And congratulations on your acquisition.
Thank you.
This is a big property, isn't it?
It is indeed.
And what do you propose to do with it? And why did you pick this one?
Because of the state it's in, to be honest. We love finding properties that just need doing up, and this one especially. It had a lot of damp, a lot of roofing problems. It's on a nice piece of land, so we could see the potential with it. We're going to change into a 5-bed executive house, so at the moment it's only a 3-bed.
But with the rear extension, we're going to create 2 more double bedrooms, so...
Wow, is it double height, full height?
Yes, yeah. Where the conservatory is, we're going to remove that and create a nice kitchen, dining, family room.
Oh, what, the big yes. All-encompassing...
Absolutely, yeah.
...kitchen, diner, living space.
Yes, yeah.
An ambitious project.
Absolutely, yes.
And you're not scared by it?
No, very excited by it, actually. Yes.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, definitely. We've done refurbs before, but we've kept within the same dimensions, whereas this one we've decided to, yeah, make the most of the land and everything else that we've got with the property.
Well, you said we, so what does that mean? Do you used to put your building clothes on and get
I'd
stuck in?
I'd love to. But our builder won't let us, really.
Who does we encompass?
So we have our build team, which we've used for all of our previous projects, and currently also is working on the 2 that are ongoing.
So you've got 2 projects on the go now?
Absolutely, yes.
And this one, you're going to start when?
As soon as the planning comes through. So 8 to 10 weeks' time, we're going to get the asbestos removed from the garage, get the garden cleared, we'll get everything cleared in readiness.
So what sort of budget do you think you're going to need for doing this?
We have budgeted £150,000.
And provided they do get planning, they think it will take them 6 to 8 months to complete the work. If they don't get planning, they will just do a full refurb of the three-bed house, which they could sell on or potentially set up as serviced accommodation, which is another part of their property business.
Well, it seems that your team has been very successful. How did you actually meet and come together?
So it's been, what, 2.5 to 3 years now when we first met Trevor and Julia. They actually sourced us a couple of properties. We were living in London and we were looking for properties outside of London and found both Trevor and Julia through our sort of property network.
Who's the technical guy?
Killen. He's a techie person, so he's our go-to techie person for sure.
Oh, right.
Trevor's the numbers, I'm the pictures, and we're the sort of design team.
Yes, absolutely.
So, yeah.
Seems like
a
marriage made in heaven.
Absolutely. Yes, definitely.
Well, I can't wait to see how it turns out. I'm really going to be interested in this, to turn this into a five-bed, super-duper home.
Yeah,
I'm really excited.
We are too.
We are, yes.
Yeah.
Can't wait.
Good luck and bon voyage.
Thank you very much.
Rimple and Julia and their partners, Trevor and Kalan, really seem to be enjoying their time in property development. However, this is the biggest project they've taken on so far, and it does need full planning permission to achieve full development of the existing property. So that begs the question, what are we going to find when we come back? You can find out later in the show.
It's been a while now since we visited our two remaining properties. Now, there should have been some work done, but you never know.
Yes, all sorts of problems can arise. What have our buyers had to deal with? Let's find out.
Back now to South Yorkshire and the town of Mexborough, where Dion saw this two-bed end terrace with an attractive guide price of only £10,000.
Central heating is in, double glazed windows as well. The room itself is an OK size. It's not massive, it's not tidy, it's just dated, and it needs decorating.
It was in need of TLC, but upstairs there were two good-sized bedrooms and a bathroom. The only slight area of concern was in the kitchen.
We have got a couple of issues in the kitchen, bit of damp, and I can see that there has been some water damage, but there's loads of space to play with here. You've just got to get it right, but you've got some work to do first.
Someone who wanted to take on this two-bed end terrace was Eddie, here on the right, who paid £42,000 for it at auction. His friend's dad, Michael, was an experienced property developer who was going to do some of the work alongside his son, James.
First and foremost, what's the relationship here?
So, James, who's Michael's little boy, Michael's son, I've been friends with him for about three to five years, and he's always said his dad is into, this type of work, renovation and building. So I said, this is...
This sounds good.
So, why don't we link up, I guess? Let's see.
He thought he was going to get family and friends rates. He's not. Can we celebrate the end?
I'm asking for a friend. Eddie was going to be handing over the project management and some of the building work to Michael and James, who was going to learn the ropes. Eddie wanted them to keep the original layout, but modernise throughout, adding a new kitchen and boiler. They were going to redecorate, and they would investigate those signs of damp. Eddie had given Michael and James a budget of £15,000, and they were hoping to complete the work in only 3 weeks. We've returned nearly 4 months later to see how they got on.
I'm asking for a friend.
As planned, Michael and his son James carried out the work here, doing some stuff themselves and organising various trades to do the rest.
Eddie obviously was, he bought the house. We spoke about what the budget would be, and then he sort of left it to me.
80% of what's been done is down to Jamie. I'm really proud of him. He's really done it.
The living room has been freshened up and the fireplace has been tiled.
I got some inspiration. I was up at my girlfriend's father's, well, girlfriend's parents' house, and they'd done something really nice with their fireplace with some tiling. And I saw it and I thought I'd like to try that one day, so I brought it back, showed Dad, asked him what he thought, and he said, I'll show you how to tile and then you can do it yourself.
Anybody comes to visit, it's going to be that. I did that.
Yeah, but what about the kitten?
They say that the kitchen's the heart of every home, so we decided that the kitchen was where we were going to sort of spend most of the money and time. We then realised that we had to take the kitchen, almost all of the kitchen, back to brick. That was a bit of a mission. The plasterer sort of took his time, so delayed us a little bit, but it had to be done, and it made a big difference.
Taking the kitchen walls back to brick might have caused a few delays, but it also meant that Michael and James could get to the bottom of the damp issues, which have now been sorted. They also got a qualified plumber to install a new boiler. But something they hadn't anticipated was rewiring the house throughout. This was carried out by a certified electrician.
Didn't need to do too much in the bathroom. It was in pretty good condition already. So the bathroom was a nice little easy job of just getting it clean.
This was James's first go at project managing a build like this, learning from his dad along the way. So how does he think his son got on?
Jamie takes things on board very, very quickly. And that's why it's worked so well. The next one's yours, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'll always be there.
Michael and James are delighted with the end result for this two-bed and terrace. But the owner, Eddie, hasn't seen the property yet. So the big question is, will he be impressed?
Yeah, I think they've done really well, if I'm honest with you. They smashed it, you know, looking in the kitchen, the finish, the detail, you know, it was a big improvement. So, 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10.
It's top marks for Michael and James.
It's been a team effort, right? So obviously James and Michael have been very active in the field, should I say, in terms of the, you know, day-to-day renovation work. So my role essentially, I guess, is management of the project, I suppose, yeah.
The original budget was up to 15 grand, but did the sums stack up? I want to get it out of
here. We definitely exceeded our budget. The final figure is in about 18, so not too shabby.
Definitely not, especially with the extra work they've had to carry out with rewiring the house and taking the kitchen back to brick. But what does a local estate agent think of the work carried out? We invited one along to get their thoughts.
I think it's lovely. I think the owners have done a really good job. They've made it look really light and airy, ready for somebody to move straight into. Yeah, I think it's a really good project that they've done.
After some consideration, Eddie has decided to rent the property now that the work is complete. So what sort of returns could he expect?
If you were to put this property on the rental market, I believe you would achieve in the region of £475 to £500 per calendar month.
In terms of top, so ceiling, I'd probably have it a bit higher, if I'm honest, probably about £550, £600. Those were our numbers.
If Eddie was able to achieve his top figure, that would be an annual pre-tax profit of just over £7,000, giving him an impressive yield of 12%. But what about its resale value? He's invested £60,000 in total, so has it been worth it?
If I was to put this property on the open market, I would say you would achieve roughly in the region of £75,000 to £80,000.
That sounds good. Fair enough. I think we're sort of seeing eye to eye now. But that's what we was sort of, I guess, where our sort of realistic target was.
Taking the agent's top figure, that would be a pre-tax profit of £20,000, so it's definitely been a smart investment. With the help of his friends James and Michael, they've all been able to make this project a success.
With James, I'd say, you know, round of applause. He's given nothing but heart dedication to this project. And Mike, he was a great leader for us. And I'd say 10 out of 10, they did really well.
Back now to Whittlesey in Cambridgeshire and a detached three-bedroom house that Tommy saw, where the problems were raining down on it.
Because it's flying over the top of the guttering, down the wall, and blowing all the plaster off the wall. And it does more than that, it does structural damage over a period of time, because wet and cold, it expands, and then when it dries out, it shrinks, and that's how you get structural cracking.
So there were concerns about the structural integrity of the house, but the space it offered both inside and out were impressive. Not only was there a big reception room and three good-sized bedrooms and a large bathroom, there was also plenty of land at the back and a huge garage workshop. So that P word, potential, was writ large on this one. It was bought for £209,750 by Julia and Rimple, who together with husbands Trevor and Killan run a part-time property development business. And they had big plans for the house. Give me just a little
more. We're going to change into a 5-bed executive house. So at the moment it's only a 3-bed, but with the rear extension, we're going to create 2 more double bedrooms. So
wow, is it double height, full height?
Yes, yeah.
An ambitious project.
Absolutely, yes.
And you're not scared by it?
No, very excited by it actually.
So, provided they got planning permission for the extension, it was ambitious and exciting. They were looking to spend £150,000, and with 2 other projects on the go, once they got started on this house, they hoped to complete the work in around 8 months. Now, 5.5 months on, we're back. Indications from the front are that there might have been some major structural work needed here.
So when our builder and his build team started pulling down the ceilings, lifting the floors up, they raised quite a few concerns regarding the structural stability of this building. We found that most of the doors and windows didn't have lintels, and those that did, the couple that did, were literally rotten. The RSJ that runs from the back of the building to the front actually stopped here in the lounge. So again, there was no support for the rear of the building at all. The 2 side external walls were single skin bricked, and these needed metal ties put in just to hold the 2 walls together.
Wow, it did look like there were some structural issues, but not to this scale.
Our builder actually said to us it would have been cheaper to knock down and start again, but obviously, as it's in a conservation area, there would have been a lot of hoo-ha about being able to do this, so we've made it, going to make an ugly duckling into a beautiful swan.
But at last, it's structurally sound, and with the roof repaired, it's weathertight too. And they've got the planning permission for the extension, so they can shape what they've now decided to be a 4-bed house.
What was the original kitchen is now going to become our utility and downstairs shower room. And what was the dining room before is now the study. And we're keeping the lounge as it is. And the extension is basically the new open plan kitchen diner.
Upstairs, we have kept 3 double bedrooms and we've made a huge family bathroom.
Then we've created a hallway into the extension, which will now become the fourth bedroom with a nice dressing area and an ensuite shower room.
Well, I think this is going to be quite the house when finished. And if they've maximised the potential in the house, they're planning to do the same with some of the land.
We have put planning in for a one-bedroom bungalow, and rather than actually building it out, we thought it would be more wise to sell it with the land permission only, so we can then put this property on the market as soon as it's finished and then split the titles once we sell it.
Having got the specialist in to remove the asbestos roof, the workshop has gone. And with side access to the bottom of the garden, they're optimistic that they will get the planning permission for the bungalow. But the house has almost in itself turned into a new build. So how's their £150,000 budget faring?
We set out as 150k. As of last week, we spent having chats with my builder. We're up to about 75k, and because he knows what budget we're working towards, once this project has been finished, we'll still remain within that set budget.
And timescale-wise, they hope to have the house completed in the next 3 to 4 months, so they're pretty much on track there as well. A 150 grand spend on top of a £209,750 purchase price does mean they're looking at around £360,000 to get this bigger and better house. So is the work they've done so far on the property heading in the right direction? What does the agent who saw it the last time think?
My initial thoughts were perhaps not to do an extension. Having revisited the property, though, I think it's a great idea. I think it'll add a sort of tremendous value to the property.
Provided they don't find any more major issues, Julia and Rimple are confident they can bring this project in for around £360,000. So what might this house be worth once completed?
With the addition of the extension and the size that that's simply going to give the property, I'm going to go with £475,000.
Sounds pretty much spot on to how we've done our figures on this property.
Yes, and that could see a pre-tax profit in excess of £100,000. And on top of that, there could be some money from the land if they get planning permission for a bungalow.
If they achieve planning permission, I think that's going to be worth somewhere in the region of around £70,000.
With regards to the land development, we were hoping to achieve around £70,000. So that's in line with what he's saying.
So that really would be a healthy bonus. But whatever happens, it looks like the combination of these two couples, who are now friends and work colleagues, really works well.
Our plan is to carry on working together, isn't it? I've been banned from looking at properties for the time being while these projects are finishing, but once we're up and running again, yeah,
we'll let you
wait.
Lose.
Yes, yeah.
In the ever-changing world of property developing, there are always new things to learn, so we'll have plenty more advice for you next time.
Yeah, so join us again soon on Homes Under the Hammer. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.